Everybody, my name is GB. Welcome back to my channel. Today I have behind me, I don't even know if you can see, 15 new art prints that I just got from a site called inprint.com. This isn't like sponsored or anything, but I really love like independent artists, people who draw fan art, people who have their own original characters, etc. So I follow a ton of artists on Twitter, on Instagram, and all that stuff. And my stream room has this big plain wall, right, like to the left of my monitor, so I really wanted to fill it with art, so I went a little overboard and I got all of these prints that I'm gonna hang up. So once they're up, it's gonna be hard to show them, so I wanted to just do like a little like haul video, I suppose. But I remember that Goodnight Moon had one of the most incredibly tingly videos where she traces through her sketchbook. So I'm not an artist, so I will be tracing on other people's art, but I will be sure to post the links in the description of the direct link to where I bought the print, and then to one of the artist's social media, and I'll have their social media or name or whatnot on the screen as well, because please, like, go support your faves, your fave independent artists, you know. It's kind of, like, long, so I'm gonna hold it like this. This is called A Break from Training. And it's Todoroki from My Hero Academia. This is by Zetanoia. It's such a beautiful piece of art. So this is Todoroki Shoto. It's from My Hero Academia, and he's sitting just on like a grassy hill. Little city in the background. I wonder if any of these are UA. And then the sky, a lot of clouds, some more leaves here. Wish I had this brush. Oh, I'm not holding it very straight, am I? There we go. So Todoroki, the character, he has half red hair and half white. He's wearing his school uniform, like gym uniform, because they have like their school uniform with like the white collared shirt and the tie. But this is like their gym sports uniform, I think. Honestly, his hero outfit looks very similar to the sports uniform, so I could be completely wrong right now and sounding like a total dumb. Let me see. UA sports uniform. Yeah, okay, I was right. A little stream right here. Some rocks. Bob Ross would be proud. So. I can almost like feel this weather, you know, just by looking at it. And I like that he's so iconic that it's very easy to tell that it's him without even seeing his face. So that's the first big one. I have a couple big ones, some medium ones, and then a lot of the smaller ones, which is good because they're easy to hold up. Okay, so the next three are from this artist called Vacuum, or Vacuum Chan. So here's the big one first, and this is another My Hero one. Okay, it's quite large. I hope this is in focus. That would be a big bummer. I've been looking into getting like a bigger monitor for my camera so I can not mess up the focus so much. So here are a bunch of the UA students at a festival. This is a little green outlines here, it's like a camera. So we have Kirishima, who's been really growing on me lately. Here, I'll trace with that. He has very spiky hair. A lot of the boys in the show have very spiky hair. He's got the little fangy teeth and this little candied apple here. And I always like characters with red eyes. I think they're really cool. Then we have Nina in the back. She's the pink one. And she has horns. And the whites of her eyes are actually black, which I think look really cool. And I think Vacuum did a really, really nice job with her. I think she looks so cute. Then we again have Todoroki with his signature white and red hair, and he's got the little mask up here, and he has an apple as well with his blue kimono. And then we have Raraka Ochako. A little cute bob haircut. She's got the little peace signs here. And then everyone's favorite best girl, Tsuyu. This little froggy. That's her quirk. She's a frog. Her tongue. Yum. Kiddo, kiddo. And in the back, we have Ida, class representative there. Tokoyami has like a bird head. So he's taking a picture of Midoriya from Deku. He's all in the back, posing with his like flexing arms. And then we have the temple here, and it's all night sky, lanterns. It almost looks like a cat. So there's another one of the big ones. I love this one because they're all very like friendly. I will say I miss Bakugo. Oh! Bakugo is in this, and I didn't even see him. Oh my goodness, he's right behind Mina. I didn't even see him when I bought this. He's looking bored. Too cool for this, I suppose. Oh my goodness. So that's the large print from Vacuum Gem I got. And then she has two more, and I'll grab them both. Basically getting all of the My Hero ones done in the beginning. I promise I got more than that. I'll just do the My Hero one. This one is called Melon Yellow. And once again, it's Todoroki. My favorite is definitely Bakugo. But people just draw Todoroki so aesthetically pleasing. Again, the red and white hair, scar, almost like Zuko. He's got a really hip jacket and like this tie. It's like a rose right here, and then it goes down here. He's got polka dots on the inside of the jacket sleeves, and then a bunch of like patches here, pockets. Got some rings. So very cool, very hip Todoroki here. But yeah, severely lacking in Bakugo fan art. I actually commissioned an artist to do one for me. Then, okay, not My Hero. We have this piece again from Vacuum called, I'm just looking for her watermark, but I don't see it. This is called Brothers. And this is from Fullmetal Alchemist, / Fullmetal Alchemist Brotherhood. We've got the Elric brothers here. Alphonse, who's in the big metal suit. And then we have Edward with his braid. I loved this print. This was the first print I saw by Vacuum. And it made me look at throughout the store. So they are alchemists. The show is amazing, if you haven't seen it. And these are some of my favorite characters in like all of anime. I really, really, really like Alphonse, and I really like Ed too, actually. They're looking very dramatic in this. But the show itself has a lot of like, a lot of moments where they sort of break the ice of comedy. But he's wearing his classic red jacket robe, and he has this little alchemist's pocket watch. He's got very yellow eyes in this, which looks amazing. We've got Al and Seal here. We have our last, no, not our last, our next big print, and this is by Kesey Young. It's called Diva 2. So I believe there are two versions of this. And this is the lovely Diva from Overwatch. when she is sitting on her neck. And I thought this was such an incredible print. The colors. And it's so fun. I think I really like when people do simple necks. So there's not like a lot of shading or anything, but it's a very complicated design, but it ends up looking so cool. Got like the blue stars. And Diva herself, as always, looking fabulous. She's got like the little marks on her face and her cool mecha gaming headset. Here's a little bunny charm. And it says the Korean Army over here. Very cool. So Kizzy doesn't use like a ton of colors, but the colors that are used are so bright. But it's like such a colorful piece. I really love this one. I couldn't decide between two Diva prints and I ended up with this one. And I really, really am happy with it. There's like a little symbol right here and I'm not sure what it is. I used to play a lot of Diva. Probably like the first half of my Overwatch career. But now I don't, because I play with a lot of tank mains, so they never really paid me to do that. Ever since Moira came out, which was a while ago, she's been my second. Oh, next we have one from Lords Draws, and I think her name is, let me just double check, Laura Lewis, okay. So this is our last big one. And yeah, this is the big one. 17 by 24, yeah. And this is... Avatar Korra. This is seriously such a gorgeous print. So in this one, she's obviously water bending. And she looks very concentrated. She's got like the season one hair and outfit with the little armband here. She's got her little boots and her essentially Uggs. And it's actually reflected. Really, really cool style for Korra. I'm always looking for avatar artwork and like memorabilia and decorations. This one makes me feel really like It's like a calm strength, you know? Like she looks super powerful, but it's so pretty. That's how I feel. Ooh, next is another Cora one. Let me grab it. I'm just going to change this. Yeah, I'll take these for now. I'm just realizing right now that I didn't tag this artist in my Instagram post because I didn't get this one on imprint. Let me just double check that. Okay. Yeah. I think it's just hamletmachine.com. Let me talk about this one first. So this is a fan art of Levi and Erwin from Attack on Titan. And you can find it at starfightercomic.com because the artist, Hamlet Machine, makes webcomic. But they also sell some fan art. So, in this one we have Levi. And he's on like these puppet strings. And sort of in the back there is Erwin, and I really like the mood of this. I think Levi looks amazing. He's got like the dark circles under his eyes. He's in full like scout gear. I also really had trouble finding Attack on Titan fan art that I liked, which is why I didn't even get this one on imprint. I just like went to a different website. It'll be nice to have something Attack on Titan on my wall. Okay. Next. We have Cora and Asami. And this is by Cerula Bao or Bauhaus on Instagram. And it's this really simple but beautiful Cora Asami. Negative space, but to me it looks like when they're just engulfed in like bright light, you know. Little is like a good profile shot, actually. Got Asami on the left here, Cora on the right. shorter haircut. I really like how uncomplicated this is, but like so nice looking. I'm a very seasoned art critic, clearly. Khaleesi, King of the North. Obviously the fire and the ice. Song of Ice and Fire. Okay. I love looking at this one. It's so good. So she's like warming him up almost, and I love that he's just like looking directly at her. I don't know about next season's plot, but I like this. I have no idea where they're gonna take it. I really don't. Last season of Game of Thrones was like some of the best television I've ever seen in my life. I'm definitely doing a walkthrough of it soon. And I really like that Liz kept it very plain around them, so the focus is all on them. It's like really nice. I love it. And next, we have from Anna Didman, or Anna Did Art, another Game of Thrones piece, and it's called Khaleesi, very appropriately. How beautiful is this? Oh my goodness, goodness, goodness. I'm afraid the lighting isn't gonna do this print justice, but I just love how this looks. She looks so beautiful, and it goes with this light, dark, like yellow, green, blue. And we've got one of her dragons. Some faint, like, either cities or mountains here. Another tail here. And she... looks very elegant. Her face, she's literally an angel. The long curls. Hair like literally goes all the way down to there. Seriously. Beautiful. Obviously. Obviously. So I kind of like the difference in style. You can see like the two Khaleesi's, they're very different. Artwork. So, what I want to show you. By an artist who's not on Instagram, but her Twitter is Matcha V. So it's either V or Vi. But just Vi. And they're also tagged as Tofu V or Tofu Vi as well. I think that might be their Tumblr. I'm not sure. But this is. Oh gosh, I can't tell again if you can see it because of the lights. But it's Howl from Howl's Moving Castle. Again, just like a beautiful, like, portrait. And, like, the few colors, but on, like, very detailed, like, you can see, like, small. I'm just, like, so impressed, and, like, I'm, like, in such a good mood when I look at, like, good art, and just the fact that all the artists have their own style, but that so many styles can be so aesthetically pleasing and so fantastic. I just, like, I don't know. So we have Howl looking very beautiful. What's the point of living if you can't be beautiful? Like, it's a little star. This looks like a constellation. So he has on his jacket that has the yellow trim and like the little blocks of color. Got a little earring here too. Very long eyelashes. I feel like I, like, gasped out loud when I saw this one. I wanted something from the Studio Ghibli film, and, Howl's was always my favorite. Okay, so the last four that I have are all from the same artist, Punziella Pauline, and she is the artist who did my merch. I'm still, like, blown away that she even agreed to do that, so, like, bless this beautiful artist. Style one of my absolute favorites, but she loves all of my favorite fandoms. She's actually obsessed with Bob's Burgers as well. I'm like, you are okay. So I'll start with the smaller one. So this is Victory, or Victor and Yuri from Yuri on Ice, and although I have, like, I don't think this show's the best in the world. This is the best fan art of them that I've seen, I think. And they really are quite sweet. I love the backlighting on this. See how, like, they have the white outline of Victor's hair here. Ring is, like, glowing. I beautiful wound. And then, from the Met Gala. This year it was the, I think this is what this is from. It was like the Catholic themed fashion event. So like there's like a theme every year for the Met. And I want to tell you exactly what it was called. Let me show you Ariana Grande at the Met this year. So this was her. Hopefully you can see that. And then she got like the big bow. That's how Bunziella drew her. And I love Ariana Grande so much, and I thought her look was stunning, and then Bunziella drew Ariana in a stunning look, and I was like, boom, 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 that's all I need. I think she did a whole Met series, actually. The dress is gorgeous. She's got like Ariana. Kind of like adorable pout face, just like huge eyes, like dark eyelashes, lips, and her hair pulled back, giant bow. And it's always like, it's so interesting how like such a large dress can be super flattering, you know. It almost looks like a face. These like blue kind of goes down. She looks like Cinderella, like a really fashion-forward Cinderella. I thought this was really interesting and sort of a break from all of my fictional fandoms. I would get something like that. So, that one was called, I think it's just called Ari. This next one is just called Mercy. So I finally got a print of my mane. Oh, Mercy. And this is the, I think, called Winged Victory. This is like my least used skin that I have. But again, Bunziella blows it out of the water, makes her look absolutely stunning, and I am so picky. Mercy prints. I don't think like anybody does them well. And then I found this one. Cat eye. She's got the branchy leaves. Pink wings. Same sort of leaves here. And then it's kind of like a toga-y garment. Straps on the legs. So it's really nice. And I just got the Mercy figure from Blizzard. So I'm all set with my Mercy gear. Okay, so the last one, the last print that we have today, again from Bunciella, so the last four were from her. And, oh, I just realized why it looks like a face in Ari's dress, because it was a face. Okay, okay. This is called Fire Nation Babes. Oh, yes. So we have some OG Avatar The Last Airbender. And, of course, we have May and our favorite Azula. Look how perfectly she drew her bangs and that smirk and those eyes. Gosh, they look so cool. Girls in high school that I like. I'd be too afraid to talk to you. Super cool jacket. Sneakers here. Tylee looks super sporty. You can see she still has like elements from her Avatar outfit, like the midriff, like cut off with a skirt instead of pants. She has like the striped socks. Really cute. Azula looks really sassy, and May looks super bored. But they are so fierce. These are all the ones going up on my wall. Of course, I have a lot more art in my room, so if you're ever in stream and you're curious on what's behind me, you can always ask. And so I just wanted to do this little video that got very long, classic, for a I hope you enjoyed, and I will see you in the next video.